Welcome to Ammo Wrestling, episode 90. Coming to the ring first, he is part of the Gambit. The matchup is a tag team contest. He is Joshua Lockhart. Team partner. Dante Ashford.
Stand up. The champ. Scott, you your boy in the booth, nigga.
About to take you off the kitchen.
Godzilla bankroll, stones from Cillion. Yo, I ain't got it all. That means I'm barely home. Trailblazer, stay ballin' with vengeance. My odds is crafty dogs. Why y'all stuck on Laffy Taffy wondering? Yeah, how did y'all niggas get past me? I've been doing this before Nas dropped the nasty. My waddles, I did them up. Them bricks, I sent them up. My raps, I bit them up. For that, now stick them up. 10-4, good buddy Tone got his money up. Worth million, still back your bitch looking for me. What? Y'all staring at the angel with death. Liar, liar, pants on fire, you burning up like David Koresh. This is architect music, verbal street opera, pop a tech man. Flow, he got the projects booming indeed. I ran through the tunnel, terrorized speed, that's when I was.
And their opponent, the tag team of. They are your Ammo Wrestling Tag Team Champions. The tag team of Leon Stark and Chandler Finch, the Grind.
There barely was a lesson learned. Cause it will return no favors back to me. I'm sure it tasted oh so sweet, but it was never good enough for me. I bit the tongue behind my teeth. It was never good enough for me. You say you always keep your word. Show me what you're after. I thought you promised me the world. Tell me what you're after.
Matchup underway between these two premier tag teams. Lockhart getting a big back elbow off the bat. Now up and dropping Chandler Finch top rope. These two tag teams, well, the Gambit, are vying for those tag team titles. Win here in tag team action one-on-one would be huge and probably put them in that contendership spot right out the gate. But the Grind have never backed down from any challenge. Say we'll fight anybody for those belts. Big back elbow there. Going for the takedown now. Grabbing a hold of the leg. Getting back up onto his feet. A hold now. Takedown into that headlock. Wrenching away. Now walking back over. Tagging in Dante Ashford. First time in this matchup now. That's Chandler Finch possibly looking to tag in Stark and can do so. Into the now Stark. A big fury of offense and off the ropes into the Bulldog. Up and over he goes. And big kick straight to the face. And the sunset flip, putting Dante in some precarious situations early on in this contest, might just be what separates, you know, the two teams. Of course, some of the other teams, the squad, my team of Nikolai, who's in action here later tonight, and Saul Dempsey. Teams might be looking to form to get a shot at those tag team titles as well. But right now, this is a division led by the grind of Stark. Tagging out, and Dante now has the opportunity to tag in the Lockhart as we're getting some one and one trades. But immediately Finch tagging back in Stark. We now have Lockhart and Stark first time in this matchup now, grabbing a hold of the wrist, walking over to the corner. And then flying down on deep arm drag there. Going for that kick, getting caught, and Lockhart with it, getting taken down all the same. Grabbing the hold once again, walking over to the ropes. A Stark, always a dangerous man. Drop down into hard lock, but Stark able to fight out of it early in this matchup. Gonna have to be something to possibly revisit later on in this matchup as we're starting off hot with episode 90. Kind of a crazy number to realize you've kind of hit. From a production standpoint, and you've been doing this for this long now. And we're only getting better and better every single time. As just the future of this company is held by these four men in the ring. I think we'll be doing just fine. This is a part of a larger show, larger thing in general, as Leon Stark bouncing off the ropes, last shot. One, two. No, just the two count. Can't put away Dante Ashford just yet. Tagging in Chandler Finch. Chandler might have the opportunity to deal the final blow now. Moving him around, neck breaker. But now Dante Ashford finally having that opportunity, getting back into this matchup here. Up and down! Up on his feet once again, comboing up forearm after forearm after forearm, and off the ropes with a clothesline. Now Lockhart, an illegal man in this matchup, and now looking heartlock on Chandler Finch. Wrenching away at the neck. Tagging in Stark now. Back and forth still underway between all of these teams, but a kick to the face of Joshua Lockhart, sending shockwaves. And now Ashford Finch going at it once more. Finch all the way around into that arm, kind of just, you know, that suplex with the arm deadlocked behind him. And now looking, is this the Tequila Sunrise? I can't see if he's got the arm or the leg. Either way, ineffective. He's able to roll out. Going up, oh, taking him down. Finch getting some hops behind that one. Almost uncharacteristically, but what a clothesline, sending him outside of the ring. Tagging in Chandler, well, tagging out Miss Chandler Finch. Leon Stark back to being the legal man in this matchup. Dante Ashford throwing hands with everybody and just everybody. Everybody and everybody in this matchup so far. I don't even know if he realized that there was a tag. Just kind of got back in the ring and just started throwing. Finch now back inside the ring and going up, man down! Into the cover. Two. No! Kicking at the chest now of Dante going high. Up. Dragging him to the corner. That arm drag once more. The offensive weapons for the grind. I've never looked more lethal, but Dante and Josh both seemingly have welcomed that sort of competition, that sort of, you know, they share that same sort of goal in this defensive battle. They're looking to make it a more defensive versus offensive sort of thing, as you can see that. Rings of Saturn locked in. Broken up once more. Going to the cover now, but grabbing at the ropes. The grind. I've not held these titles this long by sheer coincidence. They just keep working. They keep getting better and better as a team. And back and forth, back on that arm. Finch possibly looking to set up in for a Kimura in the near future. But right now, going back to the side of the Gambit. Focusing on the leg, sending him into the corner now. Chopping at the chest. Trying to wither and break him down, as these tag matches typically tend to try to go the distance. And up and down, Lockhart just sends him. Getting him up on the ropes. Now sending him to the apron on the outside. Lockhart getting up, pile driver, and jumps off the apron. head first. Somehow Leon Stark still walking. After that pile driver, able to tag back in Chandler Finch. Then Finch will send him to the outside. Settled this last little bit, possibly on the outside. Finch and Lockhart take down into that headlock. Finch really working that arm. I think it bent and just sort of twisted in a somewhat sickening way. Tagging back in Dante Ashford. Trying to combo up back inside the ring, sending him to the outside as Finch feeling comfortable on the outside of this one. For the moment, I don't know if that's I'm going to try to neutralize your technical ability by making it a place where you can't possibly use it as effective. And now Finch going up and over, standing moonsault. But Ashford back inside the ring, that's the crux of this. You can send him to the outside, but man down by Chandler Finch on Dante Ashford in a two count. This Finch kind of get the breath in the back of the head by accident, and he gave him a quick apology. Sending him off the corner, big back elbow there. So now sends Chandler Finch into his own corner, another back elbow. Back and forth, everybody's going. You know, setting him up on his feet. Just that simple last shot standing. One, two, no. Dante Ashford finding a way to kick out at the last possible second. And spiking him back down on his head. It's this matchup here. Double foot stomp, but no, missing Chandler Finch on the outside. Leon Stark getting caught. Pump handle. Joshua Lockhart having this opportunity to be slow and methodical inside the ring. I think, you know, that's exactly what he wants for moments like this, is just his time to surgically tear down and rebuild this matchup in the face and how he wants it to be. Tagging in Chandler Finch now. Lockhart moving away out of that super kick, but getting him up, power bomb by Chandler Finch, now calling him back up to his feet. Kick to the midsection, up, and the man down once more. This time, Lockhart. And oh, only a two count, I don't even know. I don't even know if Ashford was even there to really break it up, but Ashford catching a suplex for his troubles. And a big standing moonsault there by Chandler Finch. And so once again, these two teams are letting absolutely nothing stand in the way of them and the possibility of walking out with a win here. You know, the grind, thrive on being at the top of this division. That's how they make their bread and butter. Finch on the outside, ref counting now at 7. Now, Lockhart taking the opportunity to go outside, taking out Stark. Finch coming to the rescue. Sends him into the stairs. Count of 3. Card in the ring and letting it be known, hyping this crowd up any way he possibly can. Now up and over Finch, trying to carry all of this momentum into a more productive standpoint. Back inside the ring for both parties. Chandler Finch with a lethal striking combination, now focusing back to the arm. I've really yet to see him try to utilize some of his submissions in this matchup, but right now, possibly on display, a show of not needing to. And a hold now, taking him to the ropes, to the corner, trying to possibly get a double team move, but fighting out of it all the same. Takedown from behind. And now calling him up on his feet. Lockhart getting caught once again. Man down! Chandler Finch utilizing that move so well in this matchup, just unable to pick up the win as Dante there to break up. It's now Chandler Finch trying to reach. And now Ashford moving out of the way, catching Chandler Finch. And now getting back outside with the warning from the ref. It's both men now up to their feet, same time. And Finch trying to move him over into the corner once more. And a big kick there. It's Lockhart up and down. Brain Buster. As now Dante Ashford in the ring, getting caught with a kick. Not taking him down. Count of 2. These two teams still remain defiant in this matchup. Tagging back in Stark. It's Ashford trying to find a way to finish off this matchup, and so is Stark. We haven't really seen Stark utilize his finishing move as well as Chandler Finch. That could possibly be the final move of the matchup, but sending him to the outside could be a dangerous place to be. Down there as Ashford rolls back in, calling him. Stark knows what he's got to do. They're taking it back to the outside, Kit to the midsection, grabbing a hold. And a cravat neck breaker by Ashford. Can never be comfortable in these tag team matches. What a punch to the midsection there, rolling back inside the ring. Is Stark going to have to get inside and look to possibly finish off this matchup now? And almost getting caught by Ashford there, sending him to the corner. Grabbing a hold off the ropes into a bulldog, but no! Ashford not going to let him capitalize on that, tagging in Joshua Lockhart. Lockhart might be the fresher out of the two at this point in the matchup. I don't think anybody's fresh. A Stark picking up an interesting game plan right now is Chandler Finch tagging back in as well. It's interesting. It almost seems like they've decided to tag out when they've started to kind of get some momentum, but now Lockhart all the way around, grabbing a hold of the leg, taking him down, focusing back on that knee. Now, big elbows to the midsection, getting that separation. And all the way around, Chandler Finch back in control of this matchup now, stomping, but no, grabbing at the head. All the way around, grabbing at that leg once more. And now, trying to get him back around, but no, a repeated situation. This time, Finch not able to get that point and that tilt-a-whirl, and now Heartlock, middle of the ring. And Chandler Finch just has to tap out. The wear and tear of the matchup got in the way, and Lockhart finding the perfect opportunity to bring back out that heart lock. We saw it early in the matchup not used, but probably to its full potential late in the match, though, as the Gambit, Lockhart, and Ashford pick up a huge win. Possibly solidifying themselves as tag team contenders by doing so. As now we move on to our next matchup of the evening. Moving on to our women's action of the night. Coming to the ring first, she is Rowdy Roxanne Elkins.
Yes!
just an ordinary girl, Selena Violet.
I'm exposed, and it's no big surprise. Don't you think I know exactly where I stand? This world is forcing me to hold your hand. Cause I'm just a girl, a little lonely. Well, don't let me out of your sight. Oh, I'm just a girl, already a fatigue. So don't let me have any rights. Oh, I'm ready to clear. The moment that I step outside, so many.
That is the sound of the bell kicking this one off here. Roxanne trying to get some strikes in early, but Selena not gonna allow it. Chop to the chest, and oh gosh, just a hair sort of grab and a pull backwards as Selena now just laying fists in to the face of Roxanne. As Roxanne hasn't necessarily been on the hottest streak as of late, hasn't necessarily been on the coldest either, but trying to find that groove. I made her a one-time Ammo Wrestling Women's Champion. Selena Violet, on the other hand, has found that groove once again and has absolutely just been running with it. But Roxanne might be one of her toughest challengers this time around. But the big double knees from Selena going up, double Meteora. That's jumping Meteora taking down Roxanne could be the difference maker. And oh, Selena back up on her feet, meeting a face buster of sorts from Roxanne, but the leg caught dragon screw. Selena is a very well utilized technical element to her game as we get this double leg Boston crab. Roxanne facing the longer side of the ring, trying to figure out the best way for her to actually get over there, but into a cover, but not even a kick out at one. Catching the leg once again, Selena. Oh, and they exchange, catching the leg there. Grabbing at the leg once more. And that pull down yet again. There's nothing more effective in a match than just a simple way to get your opponent down on the mat, but Roxanne able to do so in incredible fashion for that satellite DDT, comboing up strikes, and now Poison Rana! As Roxanne putting Selena in trouble early in this contest. Now top rope. Oh gosh, spiral tap into the cover. One, two, and no! Ref having to make sure the shoulders were down. Before actually getting that pin, could have saved the matchup there. Now rolling back over into the cover. One, but no this time. Roxanne gets to kick out. Going big with that sweeping sort of side kick there. But again, these trading of kicks have been the most effective. And Selena now goes up and oh, what a DDT. with women almost mirroring each other when it comes to their offensive game plans. Up on one side, Roxanne able to hit another just incredible tornado DDT, so hit that satellite DDT earlier. And Selena able to sort of level it out with her DDT we just saw just a couple seconds ago. The back and forth still underway. No catching the leg once again. And almost sort of corkscrew-like monkey flip. Top rope looking spiral tap. This time Selena moves out of the way, saving herself in this matchup, reversing Roxanne's attempt, and now going all the way up and around, and ultraviolet locked in. As Roxanne has no choice but to tap out, and Selena is still walking white hot. And I don't know if there's anybody she has not been able to pick up a clear, distinct victory over besides the champion, as we are looking at your number one contender for the AMMO Women's Championship. We now move on to more action this evening. Coming to the ring first, he is the Russian Rampage, Nikolai Pavlov.
Yourself, I take you on a trip down memory lane. This is not a rapper, I'm slinking crack or moon cocaine. This is cold a second, plenty cognac and major pain. Not the drill sergeant, but the stress that weighing on your brain. It was me, El Boogie, yeah, yeah, YG Lucky, ride down Rosecrans, it got ugly. Waving your hand out the window, check yourself on warriors and coldness. Hope euphoria can slow dance with society, the driver seat the...
And his opponent, he is the AMMO Wrestling Pure Champion, the Dog of War, Donovan McNeil.
Welcome to Exit 13. I am your host, LL Cool J. You said I was finished and Father Time was to blame. You disrespected my legacy and threw dirt on my name. Told DJs he's over, he ain't spitting the same. What he says is irrelevant, hip-hop culture is James. When I walk in the room, young boys look at me strange, as if I am a relic from some long-forgotten game. It makes my blood boil, turns my eyes to flames. I built an empire, they tried to kick me out in the rain. So I called on an inner power, it's hard to explain. It's like the Holy Spirit utilizing hip-hop slang. I'm beyond the gold grills and logos on change. You see, I changed rap forever, I elevated the game. Launched the greatest label in the history of rap, and for 24 years I carried it on my back. I've always shined brighter when I'm under attack. I might be down for a moment, but I always go
it's
back.
It's time for war! It's time for war!
This matchup starting off, and we're able to get a big German straight out the gate. by Donovan McNeil, and this mashup is sort of a slow boiling of what seems to be so far a silent feud between the team of the Gambit. Of course, we saw them in tag team action earlier tonight. And the team of Jamarco, Saw, and Nikolai. All sort of focusing around that prize and the tag team prizes that Donovan McNeil holds. I'm looking to possibly take what the Grind also holds so dearly. Could be a big night for the Gambit with all of them picking up victories right now. Nikolai looking strong. And a half and half. As Nikolai trying to set the standard, stepping in on the arm. Of course, last week we had Jamarco versus Joshua Lockhart, and Jamarco with another hard-fought victory. In one corner, you have the old-school pure mindset of, I'm going to make you, you know, I mean, the technical, and then you just have the brutality that Nikolai, Jamarco, and Saw kind of possess deep within them. And you're setting up McNeil straight on that barricade. And a clubbing blow back and forth, and oh gosh, what a kick. Trying to send Donovan McNeil through the uprights. And now getting him arm down, double foot stomp. Sid's just brutal on the outside, trying to pick apart every single piece of Donovan McNeil he possibly can. And now grabbing him by the arm once more, showing the technical side of the brutality that they commonly possess. Another kick down. Back up on his feet, up in the air, and oh, another clubbing strike, but a takedown this time by Donovan McNeil. And a kick straight to the back. Up on his feet, back and forth. Going back down to the ground yet again, really kind of focusing in on the arm. I don't know if that's something that he saw that, you know, he just sort of enjoys now when it comes to this matchup, or there's some sort of injury history there that I'm currently unaware about. But Nikolai really hammering it, laying it on thick, and able to pick up a two count for his troubles as well. Not getting him up on his feet. McNeil already moving slowly, grabbing a hold, getting him up. But no, McNeil having enough of the wherewithal to drop the knee. But already on the outside, Nikolai drives head first off the apron. You win some and you lose some. There are gives and there are takes. And right now, Nikolai is looking to take absolutely everything. As McNeil with a big reversal on the outside, sending him on in. And now rolling back in. They meet almost face to face, but getting grabbed. Moving out of the way, duck and dodge Nikolai. Going for that back chop, stopped. And a big point of separation, McNeil. Now, suplex to Nikolai. Gonna try to combo that up as best as he can, deciding to get him back up on his feet. Another kick to the midsection. And this time, getting him up. That Fisherman Buster by Donovan McNeil. For the two count, as McNeil, somewhat surprised, thought he might have done enough. Now that German suplex yet again, holding on this time. Into a lariat. Back into the cover he goes. One, two, and no, still a kick out at two. Up to the second rope. Oh, uncharacteristic most of the time for McNeil. Going big for that neck breaker, but moving out of the way as now Nikolai slowing it down, really wrenching that knee into the back as he pulls, you know, the crossed legs. As McNeil's gonna have to find a way to get out of this one, and does so. Not able to fully lock in that hold, but oh gosh, what a knee strike. Really levels the competition here. Now just slowly, methodically bringing those knees down. Get to the midsection there. Going big with a punch, but no. Nikolai getting the upper hand in the striking. And now gut wrench into the suplex. But McNeil still wanting a fight into another German. Both men back up on his feet, not able to get any of that Superman forearm. And the stomp to the back could make all the difference. Now focusing back on that arm. But bringing knees to the chest. Now back into the cover. One, two, no. Still only a count of two. As these men have not let each other get in the way of their game plan. Going up once again. This time, Brainbuster connects from Nikolai into the cover. This could possibly do it all. Two, no. McNeil finding a way to get that shoulder up, purely possibly based off of instinct. However, he was able to do it. The match continues back up to his feet. And that knee strike, I think they've just traded, cutting each other open in the middle of that ring as well now. A jumping knee strike, not able to connect. Calling him up on his feet nonetheless. And a fisherman suplex. And now McNeil. Unique submission, not the Koji clutch he's known for. But Nikolai taps nonetheless as Donovan McNeil walks out of this matchup, I wouldn't necessarily say unscathed, but able to walk out with his head held high. And that could make all the difference. As Donovan McNeil raising his arms high as we now move on to our main event of the evening.
Father time was to blame. You disrespected my legacy and threw dirt on my name. Told DJs he's over, he ain't spitting the same. What he says is irrelevant, hip-hop culture has changed. When I walk in the room, young boys look at me strange as if I am a relic.
Ammo! How y'all doing? First and foremost, y'all know who this is. It's the God of Harlem himself in the flesh. Silver Surfer shooting fadeaways from half court. Elbow on the rim and all that. Y'all still in the D-League doing layup drills, you feel me? Now, I know y'all got a lot of questions on Hollow. Hollow, baby, what's going on? You fumbled a bag at Magnificent 16. Yeah, I know. I've been through the mud. Don't you forget where I'm from. 116. I done seen it all. This ain't nothing new. But I'm going to come back stronger. But enough of that. I'm here to address a certain person. Because apparently, they can't keep my name out they fucking mouth. Dezilla. Apparently, you attracted to me. I get it. I'm Shaq Hollow. I track all the money. And then you got the balls to challenge me to a best of five? You gotta be out your goddamn mind. Stop that wacky shit. Ammo knows the first time Hollow walked through those curtains. In any kind of best of five or best of three, best of series, you name it. They got their ass whipped, Chris Midas, yeah, looking at you. So yeah, this is me accepting your challenge. And first, you want to talk about marriage? Well, guess what? You're going to be married to that dirt when I put you 6 feet under. It's Hollow, and you better remember that.
It is now time for your main event of the evening. Coming to the ring first, he is your winner of Magnificent 16 2022, the Frankenstein Monster, Luke Franklin. Of the Pit Crew, he is the American Wagon, Big Ounce. Matchup underway here. And Franklin gets almost a test drive type of match. At Denny's Grand Slam, he will go up against Mike Rummy, your Ammo World Champion. I'm sure we'll see Mike Rummy in action in the upcoming weeks. But already starting off this match, Luke Franklin throwing some knees straight to the face of Big Ounce. Luke Franklin, a sleeper pick to win Magnificent 16, constantly trying to prove himself, has yet to hold any titles in the company despite being in a multitude of tag teams at this point in his career. But right now, up and a discus punch straight to the face of Big Ounce, trying to work in that triangle just as well. Now, one thing about this matchup is, you know, we got the two heavier competitors. We also have two guys who, you know, are willing to go that extra mile to secure that victory. And that's what it takes to be a world champion. I think Mike Rummy has finally realized that in his match against Kenji, that, you know, you just got to be willing to take just that little bit more and to give out just that little bit more to really reach a new level and finally hold up that world title. So I think that matchup between Luke Franklin and Mike Rummy, while, you know, Big Ounce and Mike Rummy are on the same team here, they are very different competitors. If anything, I think Big Ounce is probably the closest thing to Luke Franklin that this locker room might be able to sort of offer. That world championship has a clear line of contenders. Following Luke Franklin challenge for the belt, Kenji Kobayashi, who we have yet to really hear or see as of late, gets his rematch clause for that title. I'm sure he will want to be on board for Denny's Grand Slam in one way or another, and Luke Franklin still finding a way to capitalize with those knee strikes just as well as anybody else. But Big Ounce trying to use some power behind him. And now in the corner, looking to capitalize, and does. Still only the two count. Luke Franklin inching closer and closer to a big win here tonight. Up on his feet. Big Ounce wasteland. Oh, and what a senton. Grabbing the arm now. I'm almost willing to say, I think Big Ounce might be the most dangerous man in this locker room. To have him as your warm-up match is essentially fighting for the world title right now in a lot of ways. You know, has held that title very closely and dearly. And now getting him up, dropping him down in that powerbomb. Big Ounce looking to win it all, but no, just a kick out at two. Now just getting the ability, stomping in the chest of Luke Franklin. Getting him up on the carry. Dropping him straight down. And the corner now, but no, Luke Franklin not going to let him possibly set up for that B.O.B., that big ounce bounce, but right now the open palm strike straight to the face, lifting him up in another knee strike. And now the Muda lock, trying to lock it in heavy. It's been the interesting thing about Luke Franklin's offense as of late is he has found a way to put in some submissions. That Muda lock, that triangle hold, have been big in his game recently. But the only thing possibly bigger is that discus punch from the corner, connecting flawlessly over and over again. Is now 1-2. Big ounce finding a way to kick out once more. And now calling him back up to his feet. Pop up powerbomb. 1-2. No. Big ounce kicking out that pop punk powerbomb. There's not a lot left for Luke Franklin to really try to capitalize on. That big ounce just hasn't seen already in this matchup. Now going for that forearm, missing up and over. And the count of two once more, getting him up and over. The suplex is now big ounce in a great position to finish off his opponent here. Just has to find the right time to hit it. No, gosh, bicycle pump kick could make all the difference, but big ounce back up on his feet. Big kick to the chest, back and forth. Luke Franklin with a move reversal. And up and over. Awful waffle. Dropping him down head first. 1-2-3. And Luke Franklin picks up the victory here tonight. Big matchups underway. A lot of action tonight. Luke Franklin, big win, as we will see you all next week for more Ammo Wrestling.